this is the Fundy Dashboard. This is a screen that you will be welcome with every time you open the software. On the right, you can see we have a quick tip of the week, and on the bottom left, you can check to see if your license is up to date. Here are all your recent projects. To open, simply double click. If there is a project that you can't see, then go to the Open Project button and navigate to your Fundy Designer project. To start a new project, then click the button here. Sometimes you will see red writing underneath your project. This means you have either removed the hard drive to which you have saved it, or you've moved the project to a new location. Just click Open Project and navigate to that project. When you open your project in Fundy Designer, this is the screen that you will see. And it's from here which you can select all that which you desire from Fundy Designer. The five buttons at the top are this button to select a new album or studio magazine. This is the button to show off your wall art. This is the button that you can design your client and marketing cards. This is the collage button for your blog. And it's this button you select to import your logo for all of your Facebook and Instagram needs. To access the Fundy album proofer, simply click on the logo up here, export for proofer, and you will be prompted to log in to your album design proofer. Another way of doing this is on the help tab at the top of the menu here, click and log in to design proofer. To access the retouching within Fundy software, there are two ways of doing this. One is by double clicking on any image down here at the bottom, or selecting this logo here, which brings up a second window, and here we have the edit tab and the perfectly clear skin retouching. This is the Fundy software image well. It is here that you will see every image you have imported into your project. To close this, simply double click the two horizontal lines here and to bring back the same again. You can also hide the logos at the top by a single click on this triangle. You'll notice that some of my images have the number 1 next to them. This purely shows that they have been used within my project. To see where they've been used, simply select and hover over the 1, and you will see that this has been used in the album. It is here you will also see if it has been used within a thank you card or wall art. Also at the bottom, you see we have the graphics, which you can include in the project, and also transparencies, which you can use both in the project and your thank you cards. You can also filter your images by clicking this button here. You can do this by selecting which of these you'd like to view, whether you have liked the image within the software or given a rating in your editing software. You can also select images that have been used in the project and also images that haven't been used should there be any discrepancies with the order form. You can also sort the images by date, name, rating, favorite status, story, and that will come onto later on when it comes to auto design. You can also make your images bigger by clicking and holding the two lines here and dragging the browser up. You can also, by hitting the tab button, go into theatre mode. Within the image well, there are two ways of viewing the image browser. The first is to select this logo here, or simply by double clicking any image, and it brings you to this screen. And there are now three options on how you wish to view your images. The first, up here, is to click and see the gallery view. We have a film strip view, and also we have a view to compare images. To do this, simply hold the Shift or Command key and select your images from here. The fourth logo you can see here simply selects the current spread selected. Within the gallery or grid view of Fundy Designer, there are two tabs, a tag option and orders. The tag option, it is here that you select your favorites, give a 5-star rating, storyboard your image, or give keywords to each image. Within Fundy software, all of the keywording, stories, star rating and favorites are completely compatible with Lightroom, Photo Mechanic and Bridge, as well as any other software that support keywording or star ratings. Additionally, in the image browser, there is an orders tab within the gallery, film strip, and comparison. By clicking on here, you can add the album, add the gallery, add some wall art, cards, and anything else to create the order within here, view the order, and print out a PDF for your client. Whilst in image browser, it is only in the film strip tab where we bring back the edit tab. It's from here, a single click brings us nicely back into our perfectly clear skin retouching software. Also within the client view area, we have the option to create a quick slideshow. To do this, simply click the play button here and it opens up your slideshow menu. As you can see, we already have 18 slides locked in and ready to go. But if you would like to add more, simply click just here. This is where we can select our background music for our slideshow, royalty free from Triple Scoop. To add a song, simply click on the drop down menu here, and you can see there is already a selection of tracks included with Fundy software. But if you would like to download more, simply click this link here. This is where we set the timing. And you can see we can match the music perfectly to each slide, giving us the duration of every slide here. We also have the option to show or hide our file names. Finally, we need to set up our pricing for all of our products within Fundy software. And we can do this by clicking on Client Orders and Edit Client Product Pricing. From here, we are given a number of options, and it's within this menu that we can set our pricing for every product that we can offer. For print products, we simply select our album of choice, and Fundy software imports all of the options available to us from that lab. It's on the price side here that we select and put our pricing in depending on our current pricing structure, and check whether we actually have the print size active or not. The same for album and books. If you have a name for each album, you put that in here, the base price, and whether you are charging per page or per image. This is the tab in which you will include the current cost of the album and then any additional costs from here. The same for our cards and our other products such as magazines. Wall arts come in two groups, and we can edit and name each group accordingly to what we offer within our own studio. We also have a name chart here for any composites that we offer. For logo and legal, we can import our own company logo, which is added to the top of each PDF, as well as any terms and conditions which we make our clients sign so they are legally bound by the proof from which they approve. We can also include the export of what size that PDF is to be. We can also toggle on and off whether we show thumbnails, the price, hide any discounts, or hide any credit line. And in the final tab, we have our tax options. We can change and select which logo we would like to use, set our current tax or VAT rate, and name the tax accordingly. We can also toggle on and off whether the price includes sales tax or is an addition to the final invoice.